Stepwise regression is a very popular method to select explanatory variables or predictors in a regression model. In this video, I will briefly talk about the advantages and limitations of stepwise regression. Then I will mention a few alternatives to stepwise regression. Let's first have a look at the advantages. The stepwise selection method is an efficient way to choose a simpler model. It saves computation time and we can track the selection process easily. Besides, it is simple to implement stepwise regression as most statistical software allows you to do so. For example, you can choose SPSS or different packages in R. However, there are many criticisms on stepwise regression. Here, I list 5 limitations. Firstly, the R-squared values of your final regression model are biased high, and this will give us false confidence about the final model with the selected variables or predictors. The method produces bias in parameter estimation. The regression coefficients are biased high in absolute value. Also, the standard errors of the regression coefficients are underestimated or biased low, which make the confidence intervals too narrow. After stepwise regression, the p-values for variables left in the model do not have the correct meaning. P-values represent the probability of finding a test statistic at least as extreme as the one you have, given the null hypothesis is true. However, after stepwise selection, the p-values of the variables left in the model are misleading. The p-values are typically much smaller than they would be if we had fitted a single model, and they are biased too low. Lastly, when more than 2 variables in the multiple regression model are highly linearly correlated, or we say multicollinearity, the variable selection becomes arbitrary. Please refer to a book from Frank Harrell if you are interested in a full detailed summary of the problems related to stepwise selection. I will show the name of the book at the end of the video. Because of the limitations or problems of stepwise regression, many statisticians do not recommend using it at all. Here, I list a few alternative methods that you could consider. Firstly, consider expert knowledge, which is actually a prerequisite of running a regression model. You should consider the background or expert knowledge in your area of research to guide the pre-selection of variables or predictors. Two general suggestions about the variable selections are: you should only remove the variable or predictors if the sign for the coefficient is not sensible, and only remove it if a coefficient of 0 is plausible for the research questions that you are answering. An alternative to stepwise regression can be a penalized regression. For example, the least absolute shrinkage and selection operator, which is also known as lasso. Lasso is a penalized estimation technique where the regression coefficient estimates are constrained. People also call it a shrinkage method or regularization. Professor Rob Tipshirani invented the method, and he has a nice book about it. I will show the name of the book at the end of the video. There are also statistical packages in R that you can implement this method. Another alternative could be partial least squares regression. This method is useful when you have predictors that are highly linearly correlated. It is also an efficient data reduction technique when you have too many predictors. However, I should note that the method emphasized on developing predictive models or predicting the responses, and it does not necessarily emphasize on trying to understand the underlying relationship between the variables. Here are some references. I would like to highlight the first two references. The first one is a book from Professor Frank Harrow. I would highly recommend it if you are interested in more details about stepwise regression, which are mentioned in Chapter 4. This book also covers useful strategies and relevant R code for the development of a regression model. The second reference is also a book, which is written by Professor Hasty, Professor Tim Shirani, and Professor Fredman. This book is a really nice book on statistical learning, and it covers lasso and partial least squares in Chapter 3. Thank you for listening.